डियर स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज प्रवीण अग्रवाल फ्रॉम मैनेजमेंट डिपार्टमेंट RIMT चंदौसी वेलकम्स यू अगेन इन टुडेज लेक्चर ऑफ ऑपरेशंस रिसर्च। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द एग्जांपल्स ऑन मॉडिफाइड डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन और मोदी मेथड फॉर फाइंडिंग ऑप्टिमल सॉल्यूशन टू द ट्रांसपोर्टेशन प्रॉब्लम। इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द मेथड्स ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्टेशन प्रॉब्लम फॉर फाइंडिंग initial basic feasible solution with the help of NWCM, LCM and WEM. Today we will discuss how the optimal solution of the transportation problem is find out. A problem is here, we have discussed the same problem for finding the initial basic feasible solution. For the optimal solution we will use the same problem. The first step is that first of all we have to find the initial basic feasible solution of the given transportation problem with the help of any of the method. Here I have used WEM to find the initial basic feasible solution, and so we have this particular initial basic feasible solution. We have discussed it earlier how WEM is used to find the initial basic feasible solution. Okay, so I have only provided the solution of WEM here. Okay, and these are the allocations 5, 2, 7, 2, 8, 10. Here the number of occupied cells is equal to m plus n minus 1, 6, and we are having 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 number of allocations. So this is the basic non-degenerate basic feasible solution. The total transportation cost, the total transportation cost associated with this problem is rupees 779, which we have solved earlier. Okay, now we will move towards the next step of Modi method. After finding the initial solution, we move towards this one. Okay, we have to calculate the values of ui and vj for each occupied cell. For this, we put the value of V4 is equal to 0. Why V4 is equal to 0? Okay. Because corresponding to this column, the number of occupied cells are maximum. Three allocations are there. Check each and every in this row. Two allocations, one allocation, three allocations. So we have to put that particular value equal to 0, which is having the maximum number of allocations. Here I have to calculate U1, U2, U3. Here V1, V2, V3 and V4. V4 has been put equal to 0. Now we will use the formula Cij is equal to Ui plus Vj for calculating different values of U and V. V4 is equal to 0. For this we will move towards only occupied cell. Corresponding to this, this is occupied cell, this is occupied cell, this is occupied cell. For this one, 10 will be equal to, the formula is Cij is equal to Ui plus Vj. This is Cij, this is Ui corresponding to this, and corresponding to this, Vj is this one. So 10 will be equal to U1 plus V4, V4 is 0. So first we have 10 is equal to U1 plus 0. So we have U1 is equal to 10. Second, 2. This is occupied cell. 60 is the Cij. 60 is equal to U2 plus 0. 60 is equal to U2 plus 0. It means U2 is equal to 60. Again, come to this. 20 is equal to U3 plus 0. 20 is equal to U3 plus 0. It means U3 is equal to 20. Put these values here. U1 is equal to 10, U2 is equal to 60, and U3 is equal to 20. Now, this is calculated value. This is occupied cell. This is the value which we can calculate. So here we will put 19 is equal to 10 plus V1. 19 इज इक्वल टू 10 प्लस वी वन, 19 माइनस 10 9, सो वी वन इज इक्वल टू 9, वी वन इज इक्वल टू 9, ओके. नाउ दिस इज वैल्यू, दिस इज ऑक्यूपाइड सेल, तो 40 इज इक्वल टू 60 प्लस वी थ्री, 40 इज इक्वल टू 60 प्लस वी थ्री, इट मीन्स वी थ्री इज इक्वल टू 40 माइनस 60, इट मीन्स माइनस 20, तो हियर विल पुट माइनस 20, ओके. वन वैल्यू इज लेफ्ट वी टू, 8 इज द ऑक्यूपाइड सेल, तो 8 इज इक्वल टू 20 प्लस वी टू, इट मीन्स वी टू इज इक्वल टू 8 माइनस 20, दैट इज माइनस 12. तो हियर वी टू इज इक्वल टू माइनस 12, क्लियर. सो वी आर हैविंग द डिफरेंट वैल्यूज ऑफ वी वन एंड डिफरेंट वैल्यूज ऑफ यू, ओके. नाउ फॉर ईच अनऑक्यूपाइड सेल वी विल कैलकुलेट द वैल्यू ऑफ डी आई जे, दिस इज नोन एज द अपॉर्चुनिटी कॉस्ट, and this is equal to Cij minus Ui plus Vj. This is the formula which is used in order to calculate the opportunity cost for each unoccupied cell. Okay, come to the this one. So in first one, this is known as the D12 is equal to the value of C 30, U 10, V minus 12. 30 माइनस 10 माइनस 12, 10 माइनस 12 माइनस 2 माइनस प्लस 30 प्लस 2 32, तो दिस इज प्लस 32. सेकेंड 50, यू 10, वी माइनस 20, सो वी हैव D13 इज इक्वल टू 50 माइनस 10 माइनस 20, 10 माइनस 20 माइनस 10 माइनस प्लस 50 प्लस 10 प्लस 60. थर्ड दिस वन 70 इज इक्वल टू 60 प्लस 9, दिस इज नोन एज द D21 इज इक्वल टू 70 माइनस U इज 60 एंड करेस्पॉन्डिंग टू दिस V इज 9, 60 प्लस 9 69, 70 माइनस 69 दैट इज प्लस 1. फिफ्थ वन, that is we having D22 is equal to C 30, U 60, V minus 12, so we have 30 minus 60 minus 12, 60 minus 12 48, 30 minus 48 we have minus 18. Next one is D31 is equal to 40 minus V, U 20, V 9, 20 plus 9, 29, and 40 minus 29, that is 11. Next one, and the last one is D33, 70 C, U 20, V minus 20, so we have 70 minus 20 minus 20, 0, and 70 minus 0 is equal to plus 70. So we will put all these values here in the table as follows. Just put it here. Corresponding to this value is plus 32. This is plus 60. This is plus 1. This is minus 18. This is 11 and this is plus 70. Okay, now we have gotten all the values of Dij. Now, if all Dij is positive, then the given solution will be the optimal solution. But if any of the value is negative, then we will move towards the further steps. Here we are looking that one of the value is negative. This is minus 18. So we'll put a dot before this cell. This is minus 18. Okay. Now what we have to do here? We have to form a loop, a closed loop. Closed loop. The number of points must be even, and minimum number of corners must be 4. 4, 6, 8. So here we will find a closed loop which will cover occupied cells only. So by covering occupied cells, we will form a loop. How it is possible? We will move towards this, sir. This one, then this one, then this one, then this one, then this one. No movement. Cancel. Move. Here, then here, then here, then here, and again to the back. This is forming the loop. So the loop will be as follows. This is, we are starting from this point and ending from this point, and we are having four corners. 1, 2, 3, 4. Only corner points will be calculated. The 7 is in the middle, so this will not be included in the calculation. Okay, now this is minus 18. Put a positive sign. Then negative. Alternate in alternate ways. Then positive. And then negative. Okay. These two cells are negative. Just find the negative cells. Allocation is 2 and 8. Calculate, find out the minimum allocation. This is 2. This 2 will be subtracted where sign is negative, and will be added where sign is positive. It means that here no allocation is there. So here allocation will be of 2. Here 2 allocation is there. Minus 2 is equal to 0. So no allocation will be there. Plus sign is there. 10 allocation is there. Now it will be 10 plus 2, 12. And this will be 8 minus 2, 6. In this way, we will have a revised solution. This revised solution will be as follows. Here we are having, on 19, we are having allocation of 5. On 10, we are having allocation of 2. On 30, we will have allocation of 2. On 40, allocation will be 7. 60, allocation was there of 2, but it will be minus 2 is equal to 0 allocation. No allocation will be there. 8, before 8 allocation was there, minus 2, allocation of 6. 20, the allocation was of 10 plus 2, it means 12. So this is the revised solution of the given transportation problem. Now again, we will find out the values of ui and vj for finding whether the given solution is optimal or not. So I will calculate the values directly. Which value must be equal to 0? Check it. 2 allocation, 2 allocation, 2 allocation, 1, 2, 1, 2. Put any of the 0. Just put u1 is equal to 0. 0 corresponding to this. This is occupied. 19 is equal to 0 plus v1. It means v1 is equal to 19. This is 0. This is occupied cell. 10 is equal to u1 plus v4. It means v4 is equal to 10. Now, this is occupied cell. This is the value we are having. This is occupied cell. 20 is equal to u3 plus v4. V4 means 10. U3 will be 20 minus 10. It means u3 will be equal to 10. Now this is value we are having. This is occupied cell. 8 is equal to 10 plus v2. 8 minus 10 is equal to minus 2. This is the value. This is occupied cell. 30 is equal to u2 minus 2. U2 is equal to 32. This is value. This is occupied cell. 40 is equal to 32 plus V3. 40 minus 32, 8. Okay. So we are having the values of U and V. in this way. Now calculate the value of Dij by using the formula Dij is equal to Cij minus bracket Ui plus Vj. I will calculate it directly. Here, look at here. For the cell, 30 minus 0 minus 2. Minus 2 minus plus 30 plus 2. That is plus 32. 50, 0 plus 8, 8. Or 50 minus 8. That is plus 42. Corresponding to this, 70 minus 32 plus 19. 32 plus 19, that is 42 plus 9, 51. Or 70 minus 51, that is plus 19. 60, 32 plus 10, 42. 62, 60 minus 42, that is plus 18. 32 plus 10, that is 42. And 60 minus 42. Plus 18, come to this one, 40 minus 10 plus 19, that is 29, 40 minus 29, that is plus 11, 70 minus 10 plus 8, 18, 70 minus 18, that is plus 52, okay, so what you are looking here, all Dij is greater than or equal to 0, because all Dij is greater than or equal to 0. So, this is the optimal solution. Now let us find the total transportation cost revised. Total transportation cost equal to same formula summation Cij into Xij. Come to the table. What we have? 19 into 5 plus 10 into 2 plus 13 into 2 plus 14 into 7 plus 8 into 6 plus 20 into 12. Put it here. 90 into 5 plus 10 into 2 plus 13 into 2 plus 14 to 7 plus 8 into 6 plus 20 into 12. 90 to 5, 95, 10 into 20, 13 to 2, 60, 14 to 7, 280, 8 into 6, 48, 20 into 12, 240. Total it, 8 5, 13, 3, 1, 4 and 5, 9, 9 and 8, 17, 23, 25, 25, 34, 4, 3, 2, 5, 2, 7, 7, 4, 3. This is the value which we are having. So this will be the final answer of the given transportation problem. Initially we were having the value was equal to 779 and this is 743, which is less than the previous value. So this is the optimal solution of the given transportation problem. Thank you.